Good evening, my friends. Welcome to the third episode of Diatheke Critiques. I'm your host, Peter Watson. I'm very, very happy to be here today, hosting a wonderful evening of musical enjoyment with you. So my turn to listen to the songs that you guys submitted. The theme this time around was Canadian bands. All genres were welcome, but every band must be of Canadian origin. So we got some really cool stuff. We've got some not so cool stuff as well that we're going to get to. Let's just jump right into it. Okay, so submission number one, sent in by Ezra_E36. Thank you, Ezra. This is one of my favorite tech death bands, actually, if not my favorite tech death band. This is Arcspire with the song Drain of Incarnation. Arcspire hailing from British Columbia, Vancouver, Canada. Let's go. Beautiful. It's Mozart, man. Gorgeous. Okay, it's been almost a minute and there's no blast beats. I'm really growing disappointed with this. Here we go. Here we go, it's coming. Here we go, here we go. Every single person in this band does what they do better than basically anybody else. Arcspire is probably the best technical death metal band out there right now. They're very, very unique in a genre that, in my opinion, doesn't have a lot of creative bands right now. There's a lot of copycats, but more do I know. 10 out of 10, Arcspire's fantastic. Canadian death metal's the best. Go listen to it. Moving right along. All right, next up. Submitted by CLS Teen Bergen. Thank you. How You Remind Me by Nickelback. I mean, man, what can I say about Nickelback that hasn't already been said? Let's dive right in. There we go. Never made it as a wise man. Chad Kroeger looking all handsome. Yeah. It's not amazing. No, I don't think anything about Nickelback is amazing. But none of it offends me either. Like, it's fine. I think they did what they set out to do very accurately. And I think largely people hate them so much just because of oversaturation. Like, there was literally a time in their heyday when you could not turn the radio on without hearing Nickelback on some station. It was just, they were in everybody's face all the time. And they've suffered the consequences of that kind of exposure. But you know what? They're fine. I don't hate them. Yeah, I mean, it's Nickelback. Look, I'm not going to rag on it as hard as people want me to, because it's like, they can play their instruments. Chad Kroeger can actually sing. They seem to care about the music that they make. I think they're doing what they want to do, so more power to them. I'll give it a 6 out of 10. I think it's just fine. Let's go to the next one. All right. Next submission sent in by Jacob_Ward10. I know this guy. What's up, Jacob Ward? This is Unleash the Archers with Northwest Passage. This is a power metal song. I'll be honest right up front. I'm not a huge power metal guy. I think it's pretty funny, to be honest. But the musicians are cool, you know? So let's see what it brings. Yeah, right away, man. I want to play Skyrim now. Somebody give me a sword and an axe. I need to cut off an orc's head. Okay, when does the song start? There we go. As far as power metal goes, it's fine. It's great power metal. I would much rather listen to this than Iron Maiden. Travesty. Okay, Northwest Passage by Unleash the Archers. It's a power metal song, man. If you look up power metal or in the dictionary, I think this is exactly what the genre is. If you like power metal, you'll like it. I don't like power metal, so I don't like it. I'll give it 6.5 out of 10, just so that it doesn't have the same rating as the Nickelback song we just listened to. Moving right along. All right, next song, sent in by Jay Shetler. 56. Thank you, Mr. Shetler. This song is called Pigeon Superstition by the band Bird Problems. Now, I was not familiar with this band before having to do this reaction video, but I listened to this song, and man, it's a good one. So let's go right in. Yeah, man. See, it starts off sounding like it might just be some generic prog song, but they throw some weird chords at you. It's cool. Big aggressive bass sound. So cool, man. Vocalist is fantastic too. I don't know if this band has more than one person who does their vocals, but if it's just one guy, then they are absolutely phenomenal because they have an incredible range, a lot of harsh stuff and clean stuff. Octaves are all over the place. Yeah! The guitar tone is less distorted too, but the bass is a big distorted bass sound, and that's a cool mix. I like it. Yeah, those vocal harmonies are so good. Those are fantastic. And it's a really bizarre song structure as a whole, but it's still a cohesive song. It still feels like one song. It's really, really well done. This was fantastic. It's prog metal. If you like prog metal, you'll like this band. But it's not generic. It's still really original. They got a lot of cool stuff. Very talented musicians. Amazing vocalist in this band. I'm going to give this one a 9 out of 10. Do recommend. Next one. All right. Next submission from the one and only Blake Steak. This is Figure 4 with the classic song Kill and Deceive. As we all do once in a while. Let's go. Cool riff. I feel like I've heard this a lot before, even though I've never heard this band. I gotta be honest, like, I just think this kind of thing's boring, you know, it's been done a lot. It sounds like Diet Slipknot mixed with Diet Pantera, you know what I mean? Like, I don't need to listen to this. There's a lot of people who do this better. Like, it's fine, it's just, I don't want to listen to it. It just doesn't really interest me. I don't think anything about this is interesting. You know why this band is boring? Because they're from Manitoba. No one cares about Manitoba. Manitoba sucks, dude. Nothing going on there. Nobody there. If you ask any Canadian about Manitoba, they'll be like, I don't know. Because it's just, there's literally nothing there. And the reason they're so angry is because they live in Manitoba. If I lived in Manitoba, I bet my music would sound like this too. So, I never need to listen to that band again. Like, good for you if you like them, fine. But, man, that was really boring. Of course it was boring. It's from Manitoba. 0 out of 10. All right. Next submission. Submitted by one John Oliver. This band, I am not looking forward to listening to this. This band is actually from where I live. They're from Toronto, Ontario. This is Abandon All Ships with Take One Last Breath. You want to hear some good, classic Toronto brutal metal? You're about to. Take One Last Breath! See, I'm not even going to pretend to enjoy this for the joke. This is the worst thing I've ever heard. I swear that this band, like, when I listen to their music, it's like I thought of What are the worst things I could do to make a crappy metalcore song? I'd have horribly auto-tuned vocals. I'd be using a stupid D melodic minor scale. I would be doing everything that they're doing. Everything this band is doing is everything horrible about music and really the world when you get into it. I despise this. It makes me sick to my stomach. Oh, here's the breakdown. You don't want to miss the breakdown. It's getting heavy now. This guy sounds talented. Take one last breath. I wish the last breath that I ever took in my life was before I ever heard of Abandon All Ships, because it would have been a beautiful way to go out never hearing music like this. This makes me question everything that I've ever done or thought or said in my life. I would give it a 0 out of 10, but I just gave the last song 0 technically because they're from Manitoba. This has to get a negative everything out of everything possible. Next band. Time to cleanse our palates, my friends. Ugh. Next song, submitted by Josh.Watts. This guy has the same last name as me. Now, this is the song Carry and Tide from Augury. More Canadian tech death brilliance. Let's go. The thing about technical death metal music is that a lot of those bands care more about how hard the song is to play than whether or not the song is memorable. And bands from Canada, Gorguts, Augury, Archspire, Beyond Creation, I could go on. For whatever reason, tech death in Canada is just the best. Their bassist plays fretless, doesn't he? Yeah, dude. So good. Individual Thought Patterns, Death. That's another album you need to listen to if you're a fretless bass fan. Augury, Carry and Tide, this is getting a 10 out of 10 for me, simply because what more could you possibly want from the genre of technical death metal than what this presents? I think this album is just absolutely brilliant front to back. If you like tech death, if you like death metal at all, progressive music, this is what you need to be listening to. 10 out of 10 for me, 2 Canadian thumbs up. Next submission, I am so excited to listen to this, sent by DVZ, not Z, DVZ. Psalm 40, Rush with A Passage to Bangkok. If you don't know who Rush is, shame on you. You're about to find out. Let's go. 10 out of 10, dude. Alex Lifeson. Brilliant. One of the best guitar players of all time. Geddy Lee, 10 out of 10. Literally one of the best bass players ever. Oh my gosh. And to do that while singing, it's such a unique voice the guy has. Come on. I mean, everybody knows who Neil Peart is, God rest his soul. Like, I don't need to tell you about Neil Peart. Phenomenal. 2112, if you like prog rock at all, that kind of music, 2112 from Rush, absolutely essential. Rush, Passage to Bangkok, a million out of 10. Rush is one of the best bands of all time. I'm a huge fan of 70s music, 70s prog rock. It's just one of the best genres, one of the best times for music as a whole. And Rush was one of the best to do that. Essential music listening for any music enjoyer. Yeah, that's that. Moving along. All right. We are at our second last submission now. Coming on the end here. I'm so excited for this song. Submitted by Jamie Santiago Longa. I'm so sorry for pronouncing your name like that. Please forgive me. I'm Canadian. It's my accent. This is the song Move by Thousand Foot Crunch. Dude, let me tell you, as a kid who grew up in a town literally like 40 minutes, or like more like an hour and a half away from where this band was formed, I listened to so much Thousand Foot Crunch. And dude, oh my gosh. So heavy. Man, I saw Thousand Foot Crunch live like 4 times at different churches they were playing at. I was really obsessed with them when I was a kid. I'll be honest though, it doesn't hold up too well. it's just hard to take seriously, you know what I mean? All right, Thousand Foot Crutch, Move, you know, it has not aged well. It sounds very much like it's of the era it came from. A lot of music sounds like that though, it doesn't make it bad. But Thousand Foot Crutch, a million out of 10, because they're fantastic. But a realistic 6 out of 10 because... All right, our last and final song. Here we go. So, our 10th and final submission. It's been one wild ride, my friends. Submitted by Don't Call Me Gene. I would never call you Gene. This is Sequoia Throne from Protest the Hero. Another Ontario band, actually. Whitby, Ontario. It's where Protest the Hero hails from. Let's go. Cool artwork. Sounds like Donald Duck, man. Queens are cool, though. Yeah, they're phenomenal musicians. I think they have a lot of catchy stuff, too. I like a lot of the songwriting. Not crazy about some of it, but it's cool. I have respect for this band, for sure. It's never listened to a whole lot of them. It's pretty lead guitar heavy music, huh? Very, Okay. That was good. I think that's a cool band. I like Protest the Hero. You know, I think they're all great musicians. That was actually a really cool song. I've never sat down and given them too hard of a listen, but I might have to check out more of their stuff in the future. I'm going to give this one a hard 8. A nice hard 8. Could get a 9 if they had a vocalist who was a little less duckish. Anyway, but that is our final song submission. All right, that is it. That's all 10 submissions. Wasn't that just a whole bundle of Canadian fun, huh? Well, thank you guys very much for the wonderful song suggestions. I think the only one of us who hasn't done this yet is Mike. And let me tell you guys, when Mike ends up doing this, he's going to hate everything you sent. Yeah, that was a lot of fun. Thank you guys very much. Have a wonderful rest of your life.